We're going to go ahead and find the least common multiple for the set of expressions that we have listed here. So we're going to start off with x plus 7 and work on factoring it down. So what are the factors of x plus 7? Well, at the end of the day, it's really just 1 times x plus 7. So we'll just go ahead and list the x plus 7 factor. Now for 2x minus 14, that's a different story because 2x and 14 share a common factor. So we could go ahead and pull out the GCF, which is 2. And when we divide each term by 2, we're left with x for the first term and minus 7 for the second term. So we're saying 2 times x minus 7 is my 2x minus 14. And then we'll go ahead and work on our third expression, which is x squared minus 14x plus 49. Now, on this example, we're not going to do the greatest common factor, but instead we're going to reverse FOIL, if you will. And so when you reverse FOIL, you need to think about what two numbers multiply together to give you that constant term 49, but add together to give you your middle coefficient, which is negative 14. So what two numbers multiply to give you 49 but add to negative 14? And the answer would be negative 7 and negative 7. And so the factorization would be x minus 7 and x minus 7. Or you could list that as x minus 7 squared. So then putting that together, we can go ahead and determine our least common multiple for all three of these expressions. And from our first expression, it says we need a factor of x plus 7. Because again, for our least common multiple, it has to be big enough that each of the factors of each of the expressions divides into our least common multiple. And so for our second expression, it says we need a factor of 2. So at the moment, we don't have a factor of 2, so we need to multiply that factor in. And then it also says we need a factor of x minus 7. Again, we do not have that, so we need to multiply it in. And then for our third expression, x squared minus 14x plus 49, it says we need to have a factor of x minus 7. Well, we already have that accounted for. And we also need another factor of x minus 7, which we are missing. So we can go ahead and multiply it in. And this would represent our least common multiple. So what you do to kind of clean it up, look to see if you have any number pieces to multiply together, which we just have the 2 there. And then any repeating factors, you want to write those with exponential notation, so with exponents. So multiply by the x plus 7 to the first power, and you don't need to put the 1. And then x minus 7 occurs twice, so it's to the second power. And then you're done. That's the least common multiple for x plus 7, 2x minus 14, and x squared minus 14x plus 49.